We copy this twice? Oh boy. Funny, we had a better experience drafting this cube on our phone up in Florida. Anyway, let's do one more. I want to get one draft that's like reasonable. Anyway, if you like what you watched today, please comment, like, or subscribe. We're just off of back-to-back 1-3s. And I guess we're learning a little bit about some of the powerful cards in the set. The one that makes the Vigilant Zombies is just super OP. So I don't even know what to do. I think like 5 color just seems like the way, so I might just end up drafting lands and then taking all the good stuff after the fact. Seems like this set really benefits just being wild with your stuff. So let's just go ahead and first take this Chromatic Lantern, as crazy as that seems. Miskin Boon is pretty good too. Miskin Boo. Let's just take the lantern. Let's just make pack one all about setting up for a really explosive multicolored deck. I always like flagship quite a bit. Oracle's really good, it gives you power 9. Tali, Oracle of Maldaya. I like Oracle of Alpha. I don't know if I like it more than say the flagship, but I've had some really fun games with this. Maybe Kinnan plays really good. I don't know. Kinnan plays pretty good with like Chromatic. I guess Oracle Maldaya would be a good pickup as well. Let's just take the alpha card. Why not? I do like me a Torrential Gear Hulk. So maybe we're headed more in the control-y direction. The blink deck is really fun. Obnixilus is solid. I like Paradise Druid. I think Paradise Druid is the safest pick this early on. Alright, let's go straight into the Visionary. Like I said, we're just trying to set up for just being able to do multicolor action. Okay, Brawl Expertise plus Torrential Gear Hulk is my kind of magic. Although Crux of Fate is really good too. Board Wipe's always really solid. Oh no, this doesn't even get the Brawl Expertise now that I'm thinking about it. I still like this card quite a bit. Pretty happy with Master of Time. We could start taking lands now, though. The bounce spell wouldn't be terrible either. Maybe that was the play. Definitely wishing I took Kinnan. Hopefully it wheels. I'm doubtful, but it'd be pretty sweet. I was thinking the green white just in case like we do get some blink cards. Having the white splash will be reasonable. Always happy to pick up a Golos. We'll see where we end up. Good start, though. Hopefully we can get some good games in where we actually win some games. Tireless Provisioner. Whenever land enters the battlefield, create a food or treasure token. Or just be able to fetch lands that you want. Or just Karn.
Evil must not be tolerated.
Like Karn. Cavaliers, fine. Relics, pretty good. Let's take the Rell. Start getting wild, I guess. It's an instant too, so we can get it back with Torrential Gearhulk. I like Ghostly Piffler. Helpfuler. Helps you draw cards. Is this a double vision deck? Maybe. Or we just take the bounce stuff.
I will protect the virtue of this world.
I'll take I didn't even see the God Eternal Vronus, so cool with that. And we wield the bounce spell. Pretty solid. Okay. Fight spell, grow spiral, land. Mirari's good. But a little bit slow. Being able to copy spells is always good. I'm going to go with that. That plus Oracle seems good. I don't mind the Growth Spiral either. I think I'm into this though. Maybe it was the Growth Spiral. I don't know. Firemind Vessel, pretty good. Jacob's pretty solid. Scuttlebutt to be able to ramp up is pretty good. Can't pay life to cast spells or activate abilities that aren't mana abilities. Doesn't seem great for our deck. I guess it's okay, but we have like planeswalkers and stuff. I think we just go for either Firemind Vessel or Jacob. I'm thinking we just secure the bag on what we're looking for. Definitely don't mind the Great Shark. There's not a lot of counter spells in this set, something I've noticed. Like, the counter magic is a little bit lacking. See, this is the type of card that is quite good if you have the mana base for it. Binding of Old Gods. Oh, see, this is the card I was talking about. This card's nuts. Do I just go for it? No, we'll just take the Binding of the Gods. I don't think this is the deck for it. Mizzix Mastery. I think it's gotta just be Mizzix Mastery, right? We're not doing what we said we were gonna do and taking the lands, though. We should definitely start doing that. Allbreaker Horror. Explore, it's kind of like taking a land. Where are all the instants? Not getting none of those. Like, Inscription's like the low end. I guess we'll just take Hangerback Walker, seems fine. We have a lot of mana. Memory Deluge, whenever you cast your first spell each turn, reveal the top card of your library, you may cast it without paying its mana value if the spell is lesser. That seems good, Rashmi. We also got Memory Deluge though, so I think we'll just go with that. Alright, we don't have a lot of fight spells, so I think that's it. Scuttlemutt, Silex. The downside of this was that it prevents our, like, Karn and other things from being able to do the things that we want them to do. Finale Beast Whisperer. Alright, I guess we just take this Jin Kataxian. Not convinced about this Nissa or this Mizzix. We'll see. Kind of a weird deck. I'm happy with Spell Swindle for sure. I wouldn't mind the Curator, but seems really good for us. I always like Reality Chip. I like Celestis. However, I do think we should start taking a... We should definitely take this blue-green land. Like, we don't even have any white spells that we want to be playing. I'll take this Nissa though. Or even Ashiok maybe.
There is little as exquisite as the artistry of torment.
Ashiok's good. Tameshi. We're going to want the green-black land for sure. Gilded Goose would be good too, but let's just take the land. It's a bit safer. Shigeki. Return it to its owner's hand. Reveal the top cards of the library. Put a land card from the top of them onto the battlefield. Return target X non-legendary cards from the graveyard to your hand. We have a ton of legendary cards, so I think we just go with this. Leer. Our top end's super heavy though. Green blue land or Champion of Wits. I mean, we got a ton of lands. All right, another green black is fine. My master is always really good, but we got a ton of stuff, so this looks good to me. Nice. Don't even mind the emerging sequence, but this gives us card draw. Yeah. We played this with this before and it wasn't the greatest, but so this Alando. But I think it could potentially be a card we want. Alright, we got a ton of stuff. We gotta figure out what to cut. I don't know if we're really like we're not really an aggressive deck for the Forerunner or the Rhonas. I think I'd just prefer the Forerunner. All right, let's do a little bit of this. We got fair amount of creatures, non-creatures. We got Ashiok, so we got bounce spell, land, fight spell. So this goes really well with the Forerunners. This helps us with our mana base. We got Binding, which is a removal spell. Ashiok, kind of a bounce slash removal. Spell Swindle. This. Maybe Elando goes. Maybe Tide Mage. Torrential with Spell Swindle is pretty good, as well as some of the other things we have. Like, maybe Finale is just too awkward. It's pretty good with, like, Hanger Back Walker, too, though. Maybe Piffler goes. I feel like we have already some decent ways to get cards. I mean, we could just cut these. Call it a day. If we did that, we could replace them with, say, Tide Mage and Elando. Meaning we get rid of like two removal type spells. I don't know if that's the play. Deputy Detention's actually pretty solid. Maybe we want to take that? No. Where's the other thing? I mean, I could see something along these lines. Just feels like a shame not to play the Binding of the Old Gods and the Ashiok. Maybe it's Ashiok that goes, actually. And then maybe like one land. I think I like that. All right, let's run this out. I think this seems pretty good. Maybe we'll make some adjustments after game one. Nice. We're gonna have a similar turn, so let's go. Try two. Draw one. I don't think we need the that guy. Oh, this is only to cast creature spells? Not loving that. I thought this was an instant. I think he got alchemy adjusted. All right, give us a land, please. Beautiful. See if they've clued into what we've just done. Because we can Burrell anything they play, right? They have Sublime Epiphany. Which isn't great. Yeah, spells can't be countered. So they can't even... They can't even counter... this. I guess they're gonna bounce. Let's see what they do. Okay. I think we draw a card off the Okay. I'm not liking the position we're in anymore. Just being honest. Our deck doesn't synergize exactly the way we want. Take a look at the sideboard again. Guess we just no block? Like, hope we draw something juicy. That's what we were looking for. Okay. Not bad. Is it enough to win? I'm not so sure. We know we can gain 3. Okay. These have lifelink. All right, well. All right, let's just concede. Darn it, man. I know we can do better than this. This is driving me nuts. In this cube. Everything we did at out and about was good, and now everything is not good. Like when we were out playing before, things were fine. Now not so fine. Do we need Chromatic Lantern? Maybe we keep Lantern and get rid of the Firemind Vessel. Sure. Stressful. Stressful playing magic. Sort of, kind of. Right, let's go. A card. Play an extra land. I think we just go Chromatic Lantern into Karn. Yeah, I'm happy with that decision. Maybe we should have made a 2-2 construct, because if we play our Tide Mage and the construct deals damage, it works out pretty good. So actually, yeah. So next turn we get him for 2, potentially. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Our card in exile costs 8. We draw a land, I'm just going to take out the Forerunner. That's good enough. Seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Farewell, and thank you for that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay. Can actually. Oh, we do have enough. Okay, so we can actually spell swindle again. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Worked out well. I'm actually starting to think we want more than we want the djinn, because we're not like a super control-y deck. Well, we are, but like, I actually think we want the God Eternal. Maybe not. Maybe the djinn's the better play. I'm second guessing myself now. Maybe instead of the djinn, we want the Ashiok. No. Yes. All right, so Paradise Druid. Another Lutri deck. We've run into a lot of those. I don't want a binding of the old gods of the fate. It seems like a waste. Wait till they play something big. You can make a 2-2, a 3-3 hangerback walker. Okay. Genesis Ultimatum. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two. Okay, so we need to kill the Land of War. And hope that they don't get to play it. If they get an island, it's... Well, that's that. Six. Nice, they didn't get it. Let's go, Urza.
I'm fighting. Allow me to introduce you to a friend of mine.
Okay. What is this deck? Like, this is what I'm talking about. What is this nonsense? This is absolutely nonsense. This deck is just nonsense. All right. GG's, whatever. Game's over. I don't understand what that deck was. That was BS. Seriously, 1 and 2. I do not like this curator. Sure.
never seen me fight. Our eyes are everywhere. Something you don't know.
Boy, oh boy. All right, so they're going to get a forest. At least a forest. They didn't take the forest.
My head wasn't in it.
What do they got in there? Something juicy. I think we just time twist because we got the power 9 in here now, so... Yeah, that was a turn. Really don't want either of these cards right now. I think Memory Deluge is fine. We'll go with that. I should have probably waited. Because they're just going to exile it now. They didn't exile it, okay. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. We can memory deluge again. I have to admit, I really like this Oracle card. Even if we haven't been particularly good with it. It's a fun card. What you got, sir? Like something like that. Fair enough. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Alright, let's end this turn. This is so wild. They're gonna be so mad when we counter whatever they do. They probably have a counter. Alright. It'd be nice if we could get some like creatures or something. You can deal with my servant. Thanks. I'll be taking that now. I don't even know what our deck's trying to do anymore. We copy this twice? Oh boy. Oh my goodness. Can we kill them? If we get the Forerunner? I think we can.
Nothing on Innistrad is free. Don't even think about it.
This actually doubles. Yeah, we're gonna copy the finale. Should be game. Discard a card, eh? Not even worried.
I feel bad for your mentor if that's your attack.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Alright, so let's just spell swindle.
Juicy secret.
Now, what creature do we have to actually search? Potential Gear Hulk?
Blood for knowledge. A fair trade.
I think that's fine. So we'll go X for 10.
First, iron out the details, then T.
How many times have we time twisted? Twice already? We're going for a third? I think that's what it is. Because we have double power 9. Oh, I can search my graveyard. Yeah. Oh my god. Sure. That was some funny magic. Come on. Holy. I'm gonna have to tag this video and say time twister the power 9 three times or whatever. I don't even know. Something along those lines. I think that hand had a lot of potential. This is worse, fortunately. I just wanted to get a 3-land hand, you know? Alright, so Chromatic Lantern. I guess we can hold up Spell Spindle now, that's not bad. Next turn. They might get a big play. Good enough.
Until the multiverse is won, we will fight to make it so. Reinforcements are near.
All right, so we can spell swindle again. As long as it's your turn. Should have played my Karn. Unfortunate. We don't have a board wipe or anything either. I guess a good draw for us right now is like
join us.
We're all expertise. Well, we got a fun deck, but apparently not a very winny one. Oh no. What a bummer. I mean, you saw the potential of our deck. I don't think there's anything that can really get us out of this mess. I'm just going to go ahead and concede. God, what a terrible, terrible day for Magic. That was a really fun game, but we're just in a crazy losing streak, and it's so, so frustrating. Anyway, if you liked what you watched today, if you liked that crazy, crazy gameplay, please comment, like, subscribe, and Brothers War's coming up. Have a nice one. Cheers. Bye.